Maybe we have to do it to love yourself too.
That's love, respect, accept, understand, and live alone within yourself to really get to know yourself inside.
Love, respect, accept, understand, and live alone within yourself. These are the things that help take the edge off of loneliness. I'm Rona Williams with Kit Borgman, and one is a lonely number. About 4 years ago, a group was started in St. Paul to try and pull men and women through the adjustments of separation and divorce. It was not to be a place for professionals. The members, through common experiences, would help each other. The name they gave themselves indicates the atmosphere of the group. They called it We Care. The founder and director, Bill Smith, organized We Care when he served as a minister at Bethlehem Lutheran Church in Minneapolis.
I had a large counseling center in South Minneapolis, and I had a lot of divorce cases come in to me and marriage counseling. And I, in spite of the fact that I tried to be helpful, there many times I just felt like an outsider. I felt like I just couldn't help these people. So what I did is I got the amazing insight to just get these people together. All of these people came together because they had a common hurt and a common sorrow. And that really is the glue that makes groups go. I didn't want to make it a group therapy model. I just wanted to see how they would help each other. And the thing just grew like tops. It was just crazy.
Today, We Care groups exist in cities throughout the country. The first group, in St. Paul, is still directed by Smith and is held each Wednesday night at the Wilder Center. Smith, however, leads only one small group. He feels the best thing he did was to get out of the way and let the people help each other. Dorothy, a woman who has been attending We Care for a year and a half, enjoys the unstructured nature of the group.
But We Care is not a professional kind of organization. It's always been really unstructured. Some hurting people sitting down and saying, look, I hurt, and someone says, God, you know, I went through that 6 months ago. Here's what I did. Mm-hmm. If it helps at all, think about it.
Reverend Smith says We Care is different from other groups of its kind in many ways.
Everything that has happened just grew naturally. You see, we have no organization, no commitment, no dues, no nothing. Another thing we do that's really crazy is whenever a new We Care group starts, a person just announces he's going to start it, and he can go ahead. And we encourage them to try to get some professional consultant in case they have a person with a psychotic break or something. So we encourage them to try to get a psychiatrist or a psychologist that would come in if necessary. And I said the qualifications are, one, they got to commit themselves to a year, they got to find a place to do it, and then they got to open it up and start.
Many people experience the same feelings of rejection when they find their marriage has failed. Dorothy found that her low opinion of herself carried over in her first impression of We Care.
I felt really humiliated. I felt like a ruined person. All I could see was, you know, from now till the grave in this horrid, gray, awful existence. I had done nothing but sit around and cry when I wasn't working for mm-hmm. about 8 months, and I finally thought, well, I have to do something. And I'll go over there and sit around with a room full of losers, and if it's too horrible, they can't make me stay, I'll run.
Some people were anxious to join We Care. Anne, divorced for 5 years, went to We Care when she felt the need to talk to someone who could understand her.
I had joined the church choir this year, but I take a lot of the kids with me. But I really had no social life of my own, and I was doing absolutely nothing for myself. Because for a while it just seemed that I had too much to do just to get my feet back on the ground and get us all pulled together. But I was beginning to feel the need for adults to talk to, something to do, someplace to tell somebody, hey, I survived, you know, because I really feel that way.
Dale has been divorced for 6 years. Because We Care didn't exist 6 years ago, Dale turned to the bars for refuge.
Served a purpose for, that's where I was at the time, go and hustle and look around. And that's where I was at. But then I outgrew that. And in fact, if it hadn't been for We Care, I probably never would have outgrown that, and I'd still be hitting the bar scene and the swinging singles and all the other stuff. I can stay at home evening and I'll be perfectly content, pick up a book or something, and be happy.
Like Dale, many men turn to the bar scene when rejection creates a shattered ego. Dick, divorced 8 months, has been attending We Care for 2 years. He found that We Care had more to offer than bars.
The biggest aspect of We Care is that it allows people to relate on pretty on levels that get would normally be not even attainable outside of places like that. This is certainly far better in most regards than a bar scene, because not only do you meet a lot of nice people, it seems to be a certain type of people that goes to We Care. They seem to be, by and large, a tendency toward being fairly intelligent people and feeling people.
The success and appeal of We Care are difficult to explain. While most members agree that We Care has an atmosphere of people caring for each other, Bill Smith offers more concrete suggestions.
I think the key is a commitment to honesty with each other. That is, the key is that when they get in here, the rules are set. That this is, you know, first of all, they tell it's not a judgmental group, it's a soft, caring group, and you can play games all you want to, but if you're not going to get help here. Mm-hmm. I think probably another key is the fact that this is a self-confrontation group. That is, people confront themselves as they share with each other. It's not a confronting group to put each other down, but it's people saying, almost declaring to each other, you know, this is how I messed up my life in the past. I want to grow through this, and I want to do this. I want to try to change.
Each member has found that certain needs are taken care of at We Care. Dorothy, who had very low self-esteem, found she was readily accepted at We Care.
We Care doesn't have all the answers, and We Care probably doesn't have any of the answers, but it's a good warm place to find your own. It's the fact that when I'm there, I am an understood person. I'm not a freak. I'm not some outcast of society. I'm not a loner struggling along. As I say, it's a place where I am understood. It's a place where I can say, I'm going to try to change and be more assertive and stop apologizing for living. So if you see me on this road to change, tell me so, and they will do that.
For Dale, We Care acted as a warning when he found himself wanting to be married again.
I know sometimes I think, boy, I'm really got to put it together. I really got to put it together now, and you know, maybe it'd be nice to be married now. Mm-hmm. Now, if I hadn't become involved in We Care, I'm sure I would be like I was when I got divorced, and I probably would have entered another marriage that would have been bad.
As a married woman, Dorothy says she failed to reach the potential that We Care is now helping her find.
Things that I pick up from people, and it's my own realization that I have not quite achieved my emotional divorce yet. I'm intensely involved in discovering my own self, my own interests, where I can go. I was amazed to discover I have some leadership qualities. After I spent my life as a follower, I want to explore those. I want to take tap dancing lessons. Mm-hmm. I'm really so interested in who I am becoming that I'm not ready to marry, and I know this.
Yeah.
It's a lot of things that I've learned from the people at We Care.
The popularity of We Care has been so great that Dick, like most members, does not miss the professional counseling of other groups.
Well, one nice thing about We Care is that it is a no-cost situation. And with professionals in it, that might be converted. It's hard to say. They have people that are very qualified in many fields that come periodically.
One professional that attends We Care once a month is Rex Knowles, a psychologist of the Ramsey County Mental Health Center. Knowles is not paid for his efforts, and so he does not upset the unstructured format of We Care. Knowles' specialty is children, and he offers insight into the problems of children from broken marriages.
I think one of the classic things we find it regularly, that children blame themselves for the divorce. There must be some way, they seem to say to themselves, that I can hold mother and father together. They know mother and father are fighting. they find themselves torn between this, and they try to act toward each one in the way so they wouldn't fight. And if they keep fighting, then they say, what did I do wrong that didn't stop the fight? The parents are supposed to take care of the kid, caretakers, but the kid takes care of the parents. You can see this. A woman suddenly finds out that her husband is leaving her for one reason or another. She very often will turn to the child for the support the husband isn't giving. And the kids aren't mature enough to accept this responsibility.
Knowles attends only the We Care group in St. Paul, and so many people from other We Care groups go there just to listen to him. Professionals are recruited in only one other aspect of We Care. Regular members who wish to lead small groups at We Care are often trained by psychologists at the Wilder Center. Dorothy and Dale are both facilitators at We Care. Dorothy is thankful for her training and feels it helped her to relate better with other people.
Well, it was 5 weeks, five sessions on Sunday mornings, and it was a lot of training exercises. This person would say, okay, group, now write down 21 things about yourself. And then he says, okay, now on the other side of the page, tell how you would use this if you were facilitating a group at We Care. And just trying to get in touch with all the things about me that I am and how I would bring them out and use them in working with other people. I was able to draw from the training a sense of confidence and competence in helping other people in the same way I've been helped.
The small group discussions are the meat of We Care. After a general meeting, people break off in smaller groups to discuss whatever is on their minds. The best way to explain what goes on is to sit in on one group in session. A young girl, confused and hurt, is trying to express the loss she feels since her husband left her 2 months ago.
Responsible for our own happiness.
The thing with me, I don't know if this sounds strange or what, but I still feel that my husband is the cause for our unhappiness, or my unhappiness. I guess the reason I feel like that is because, you know, I always wanted to try and work out our marriage because I knew we had problems and everything. Well, I don't know why, but he went out and he found this other girl, and he tells me that he loves her and he never loved me. And all this, and that makes me feel really bad. And even though I can accept myself, I mean, I really try and accept myself for what I am, I'm still unhappy because I don't have him.
Dick says that the transition from married life suddenly to a life alone is a difficult one for most people.
Most people that go through a divorce situation, the conversion from a duality of existence to a singular existence, experience a lot of the same phenomenons, emotions, and varying degrees of intensity at varying times. And in We Care, there are people varying degrees of maturity to their divorce situation. I've seen people that are in We Care for half a dozen years of and been divorced that long and are still, quote, basket cases. I think that hopefully that it's obviously a gradual thing, and you take several steps forward and some steps backward.
Dorothy admits that she found adjustment difficult in many ways.
I had a hard time getting re-socialized again. Yeah. Also, to begin to go out with men again, my whole remembrance, you know, was going out with teenage boys. I didn't even know how to go out with men. I perceive myself as being a lot more dependent than I actually was, but it took other people to point out to me that for years I'd been paying the bills and running the family while he was out of town all week, and, you know, seemed just really taking care of so many things. I didn't realize that.
You know, and I mean, that's what's making me unhappy, because he doesn't even want to try, and I feel that he's being irresponsible because, I mean, we still have a marriage and we still got a little boy. And I just feel like that.
You're talking about me, lady. So you got to be real careful, because I get very sensitive about that. Maybe what it is that he was trying to make it go, but until he made the decision that it wasn't going to work, and so he moved out.
He never tried to make it go over, though.
Did you?
I did.
Okay, so he never tried to make it go
of it first.
So finally he got real honest with himself and said to himself, well, I'm really not trying to make it go, but why keep this sham going?
Okay, but the thing is, then how am I supposed to be happy? I mean, if I haven't got what I want.
You're dependent upon him? You're expecting something from him, and that's going to cause your happiness? You're going to be sad the rest of your life. You're going to depend on somebody else to do something in order for you to be happy.
No, it isn't that I'm depending on him to do it. It's just that, I mean, he's my whole life, or he was. Oh, and I'm trying to pull myself away from him, but I just can't forget everything because I still like him, and I still like to be around him. I haven't got anybody else.
Almost everyone at We Care admits that divorce comes as a shock at first. The need to lick the wounds is great, and Anne feels We Care is the place to do it.
Well, you know, people go through surgery, and they wouldn't think of getting up the next day and going home without finding out what the doctor advises and all this sort of thing and all that. And a divorce is like surgery, and I don't care how much you want the divorce or how rough a time you've had and how great it is to be out from under, there's still an awful lot you've got to patch up. There are changes in it. You just feel empty. And it's a strange feeling, and I think that, and a frightening feeling. And I think to know that that is a natural feeling, and it's one that has to be there. You can't shortcut it in any way. Mm-hmm. That the healing has to take place, and just keep your wits about you and don't get carried away until that happens. I can't think of any better advice to tell people.
Dale chose We Care because he feels it has more to offer than many other groups.
A sense of belonging, a sense of being with other people who understand what they're going through, mm-hmm. Kind of a like a bond.
Yeah.
They've been there. They know. You know, and they can. Somebody may say a feeling that they're feeling at this time. They say, "Hey, that's just how I feel." Mm-hmm. And it's just a good feeling to be with somebody else that somebody that knows what you're going through.
Dorothy shares this feeling and tells how people relate to each other at We Care.
If I was struggling, or if I am struggling with some particular problem left over from my marriage or my divorce situation, frequently, before I even say anything, someone else's relation of their story contains what I'm looking for, mm-hmm. or perhaps I state my problem, like I have not yet dealt with all the anger I feel. No one will say, well, you should do this, or something of that sort. They'll say, when I was in that position, here's what I did.
How do you live alone?
It ain't easy. I don't like it.
Well, that's just it. You're always going to have, I've got a lot of deep feelings for my ex. I mean, I always will. That's just normal. It's a very normal feeling. And you'll always feel that way. But you've got to break it.
How?
Maybe what you have to do is love yourself, too.
That's love, respect, accept, understand, and live alone within yourself to really get to know yourself inside.
Okay, but there's still the reality of needing other people. What if there's nobody there?
New members, especially the young ones, come into We Care hurt and very naive. Dick feels that for them, We Care is a place where they can grow and discover a completely new world.
It seems that these people get an indication that We Care has some things that they need, mm-hmm. so they keep returning, and it's an education process for sure. Just being in groups, listening to the terminologies, getting some of these things explained, getting these viewpoints, realizing that there are you have a tendency to your perspective is so limited, particularly in a marriage, and now you have the perspective of hundreds of marriages to broaden your own.
That's one of my problems, is I get lonely a lot.
I've got
And
some.
I would like, you know, somebody, like maybe to have, if I had more friends that I could just call and they'd just be there to talk to, but I don't have anybody that I can just call and talk to.
I've got some names of some people and some numbers of people from We Care that I can call and talk to.
Tonight, when the meeting's over, when we go downstairs, you just run around and you talk to some people and say, hey, you know, like every once in a while I have the need to call somebody.
Right. Give me your phone number.
Yeah, that right.
Do any of you have a blank sheet of paper? We could all write our names and phone numbers down for get her started.
Oh, I feel stupid.
No, don't feel stupid. I felt that way at first and I thought, oh, heck, everybody's asking me for my name, for my phone number, if they want to call. They're free to. Like that one person said in the beginning, I almost jumped out and said, hip hip hooray, this is his home. He feels like this is his family. So do I.
Despite the vast popularity of We Care, Bill Smith says that many professionals don't like the techniques used within the groups.
There's a lot of professionals who really feel it's dangerous to let people help each other. They feel that, you know, because Joe is not a social worker or a psychologist, he has no right helping Nancy with her problems because she's all broken up over her divorce, and Joe being divorced, he can't possibly help her, you know. So there is a mindset, of professionals who say that this is really, not good stuff.
Even some professionals can argue the obvious success of We Care.
I had a very famous group therapist, Dr. Jackson, came in from California, and I asked him to sit with me one night and observe what happened in We Care. And he said that as far as he could tell, I broke every good rule of good group therapy. The many things about the way we operated was against therapy, but he said it worked. I think it's just because of a need.
Perhaps the best judges of We Care's effectiveness is not the professionals. Perhaps it is the people themselves. How do they feel after the group sessions are over? What do they look for?
One of the things that made me come here was the name of the group, and it's We Care. And that's why I wanted to come to this group, to see if somebody really did care. I mean, really. That. Yeah.
We all care because
there are so many people that say they care because they want to care. But when it comes right down to it, they don't.
Well, like Dorothy said, we've all been through the same stages at one time or another. So, I mean, we all in this group know what one another's going through.
I feel a lot better now that I talked about it.
Dale sees the answers that lie behind We Care in the faces of those who were lonely and hurt.
Oh, it almost looks like a miracle the way people can be hurting so bad and come in the evening, in the beginning, of the night. And when I see them leaving, I see them smiling. And just one night at We Care, all of a sudden, they're laughing. Of course, it doesn't carry them through the whole week, I don't think. They're going to be down again during the week. But then when that We Care night comes around again, they seem like they get refueled. And eventually I see them working out of that hurt and that depression. It's like rebirth, like being reborn.
Love, unlimited in the mind of a girl, hurt once or more before. Small touches, wisps of trust, a phone call. A person who understands, a past soothed by the present, spoken by her solitary voice, chorused in joy by many voices, sung aloud because there is love, unlimited.
I don't think, they're going to be down again during the week, but then when that We Care night comes around again, they seem like they get refueled. And eventually I see them working out of that hurt and that depression. It's like rebirth, like being reborn.
Love, unlimited in the mind of a girl, hurt once or more before. Small touches, wisps of trust, a phone call, a person who understands. A past soothed by the present, spoken by her solitary voice, chorused in joy by many voices, sung aloud because there is love, unlimited.